not to get caught with a big shot and just be smart. I know I got to fight a perfect fight, and that's what we're going to try to do.
Thank you. Floyd, I wanted to go to you and say, we talked before about knowing when a fighter's brand is ready for pay-per-view. 15 years ago, you made your debut as a headliner against Arturo Gatti. Are there any similarities in your eyes to where Tank's brand is now and who he is as a fighter in person to where you were entering the Gatti fight?
Well, you know, I believe in Tank. You know, I believe in him ever since we've been, you know, a young kid. And he's still a young kid to me, but he's also, I mean, he's still a kid in my eyes, but he's, you know, he's an adult, he's a young man. But I still see that young kid, and I told him someday you will be on pay-per-view, and it's gonna come real fast, and when it comes, be ready. It's a little different now. You know, when I faced Arturo Gatti, we didn't have social media. We didn't have the different social media outlets. I was pushing and promoting. I think my first pay-per-view, the first time I went out there, I think I've done some pretty cool numbers. I've done over 300, probably close to 400,000 homes my first time out. But, you know, these two guys probably can beat that. The reason why they can beat that, because, like I said before, it's totally different now. We didn't have the social media outlets at that particular time. And hopefully we can get 1 million buys, 2 million buys, anything is possible, like I said before, for the different outlets that we have in today's time. But both of these guys deserve to be on pay-per-view. And, you know, I'm not here to knock their skills, but I want both of these guys to go out there and be at their best and keep pushing it so we can do record-breaking numbers.
My last question is for Tank. You've knocked out so many guys early where we don't know in some ways how great of a boxer you are. This Leo fight could push you the distance. How much have you not had to show yet that you have from the standpoint outside of the power punching, just being a technician inside the ring?
A lot, you know. I think that, you know, Leo going to bring the best out of me come October the 31st. And we just got to wait and see. You know, I've been working hard each and every day on sparring bigger guys, sparring smaller guys, just to prepare myself all around the board, you know, for Leo. You know, we know Leo is coming to fight. He's want to say he's strong for his endurance and things like that. So I'm definitely working hard. You know, it's not even just about, you know, fighting Leo. It's about the whole package. I want to give the fans a great show. I want to put on, you know, a great show in front of being my first pay-per-view fight. You know, I want to not let my team down for pick me up against, you know, this task that was in front of me. And it's not just Leo, it's pay-per-view, and it's definitely the fans. You know, I just want to give, you know, everybody, you know, a great show. You know, and it's going to be a spooky night.
Thanks, everyone.
Very good. All right, thanks, Brian. Let's go to Childs Walker. Baltimore Sun, Childs.
Yeah, hey, this is for Gervonta. You had built so much momentum last year, not just in terms of the fights, but in terms of the crowds you were drawing. How difficult has this year been, just with you know, all the waiting and, you know, not maybe knowing when this was going to happen between the pandemic and everything else?
I believe as a professional, you got to be ready. You know, you got to be able to, you know, adapt to whatever come, you know, not just a life lesson, you know. I've been working out, for 3 months and things like that, you know, every day just to prepare for this, you know. So it's just I'm more grateful to be in this position than anything, you know. Forget whatever happened, you know, behind me. I'm just so focused on what's in front of me. And that's getting past Leo, and that's putting on a great performance in front of the fans. You know, I want to be able to go back in the locker room and, you know, hug Floyd Mayweather, hug Leonard, my personal team, Lauren, Calvin Ford, and the rest of the box that actually train with me. So I'm just thankful, and I'm grateful to be in this position. So it's sky's the limit for me, and I'm ready.
Well, and
even speaking to Tank, I think the last year, you know, I still give him pointers, you know, because, you know, he has a daughter that he spends a lot of time with. And he, of course, you know, he's in a position to where he can travel a lot now. And he's doing a lot of different things, which I'm proud of, that I'm able to put him in a position, you know, to be a multi-millionaire. So Leonard's been, you know, doing a lot of communicating with Tank as far as through the last year. You know, I'm always going to be, you know, hands-on as far as getting, you know, talking to him about life lessons and what he can do to become better inside the ring as well as outside the ring, and just talking to him about not making the same mistakes that I made. So Leonard can kind of touch on that subject.
Yeah. Over the last year, I've seen Tank mature a great deal. One of the biggest things that, you know, he got out of his comfort zone was coming to Las Vegas. You know, he used to train in Baltimore, and that showed, you know, where he was ready for this next step, because he's come out here, he's been completely focused. Everything that we've asked of him, he's done. He's in tremendous shape. He wants to go out there and put on the best performance of his life. And come October the 31st, I'm very confident that's exactly what's going to happen.
All right, thanks, guys.
Okay, thanks. We'll take our next question from Christopher Venegas with Boxeo TV. Chris?
Hi. Good afternoon. Buenas tardes, Leo. This question is for Tank Davis and Floyd. You guys think that San Antonio is all going to be rooting for Leo Santa Cruz, or what do you think, who has the home field advantage? And the fight ended up in San Antonio.
Well, I'm glad, you know, early on I was able to take him over to other places. Like I said, these are the things that we talk about. And one of the things I spoke with Tank about is the fans can't fight for you. So we just want the fans here, the boxing fans here. If it's for Leo, then so be it. If it's for Tank, so be it. We just want fans in there, because this is probably going to be extremely boring without no fans. Mm-hmm. But I can't say boring, but it's going to be a lot more exciting with fans, because you can't even put the word boring with none of these fighters. Leo, like I said, he got a high bio. And he's a tough competitor. And, of course, it's crazy that I don't know why both these guys right now should be ranked somewhere in the top 10, pound for pound, in my opinion. So, far as the fans, we're going to be down in San Antonio. So, you know, I know a lot of, you know, Hispanics in San Antonio. So, most likely, they're going to be rooting for Leo.
Leo, ¿tú qué piensas de San Antonio? ¿Crees que toda la afición va a estar de parte de tu lado?
Yo la verdad pienso que sí va a haber mucha gente mía, mucha hispana allá, pero también sé que Tank Davis trae muchos fans, mucha gente lo sigue, le gusta su estilo de pelea, so yo pienso que también mucha gente lo va a venir a apoyar a él. Estaba mirando que hay muchos que lo van a apoyar a él, so yo pienso que va a ser muy pareja la audiencia, y pues eso, como dice, eso... es bueno para los dos, que haya apoyo para los dos, y nomás que nos vengan a apoyar para dar una gran pelea. I think the fans is going to be like 50-50, you know, because Tank, he's a great fighter, great skills. A lot of Hispanic, they want to see him fight too. So I think the fans, you know, it's not going to matter, but I think it's going to be like 50-50 fans for both of us.
Gracias.
That's great. Thank you, Leo. All right, we got time for a couple more here. Let's go to Sean Zittel with Fight Hype. Sean, go ahead.
Hey, champs. Just wanted